Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This is Apollo Control, 120 hours, 59 minutes, ground elapsed time. We've called the spacecraft Columbia from Mission Control here to wake up Mike Collins. The network is configured so that the LEM crew, or Eagle crew, will not be disturbed. Let's join the conversation in progress.
Columbia. Good morning from Houston.
Good morning,
Rob. Hey, Mike, how's it going this morning?
Good.
Hey, real fine. While you're
saying. I don't know yet. How's it going with you?
Real fine here. Columbia, request pull and accept. We'll shove a state vector in for you right away. Okay, it's coming up now, Columbia. We're going to keep you a little busy here. As soon as we get the state vector in, we'd like you to go ahead and do a P-52, option 3, on this night pass. And then when you come on around the other side there, we'll give you a some landmark tracking information on Prime 130. And for your information, we're also going to have Tranquility Base do a P-52 when you come around the other time. And I have the P-22 information if you're ready to copy. Okay, track landmark 130 prime using P-22. And for information, this will properly position your rendezvous radar transponder. T1 is 122 plus 16 plus 05. Whoop, okay, standing by. Columbia, Houston, the computer is yours.
Okay, and I like the grid square of this crater, 130 prime, over.
Columbia, Houston, say again about 130 prime. Columbia, Houston.
Go ahead.
Roger, I have a T1 and T2 times and also the lat longitude of the 130 prime. We're working on the grid squares. We'll get them shortly.
Hey, Red, copy.
Okay, T1. 122 plus 16 plus 05. Tango 2 is 122 plus 21 plus 11 and 6 miles north of track. And do you want your 989 dice?
Yes, please.
Roger, latitude plus 01.243. Longitude over 2 plus 11.844. Altitude minus 001.46. Over.
Yeah, copy. T1 122 1605. T2 122 2111. 6 miles north. 989 is plus 01243 plus 11844 minus 00146.
At Columbia, affirmative. And at the T1 time, put your rendezvous radar transponder switch to operate. And this 130 prime is the same one that you tracked prior to descent. Over.
Okay. You've updated your information as to the LEM's position, and this is your best estimate of where the LEM is. Is that correct?
Columbia, that's a negative. This 130 is the little bitty crater there that you tracked, John Young's crater that you tracked prior to descent. And we want that for...
Oh, fine. Okay. You've given up looking for the LEM.
Affirmative. We want this for one last fix on your plane.
All right, fine, understand, thank you.
And when the LEM does his P-22 on your transponder, well, then that'll be our last shot at the LEM's position.
All right, understand. You care whether my transponder is on before T-1?
Roger, it'll be on warm-up prior to that time, and you can go to operate anywhere around that time.
Yeah, I got it. It's 24-minute warm-up now.
Roger. And Houston, the computer is yours. You can go to block anytime.
Roger, block on C-52, option 3.
Roger. And we'll see you coming around the other side. About 1 minute to go, and all of your systems are looking good.
Thank you, Roger.
This is Apollo Control. Spacecraft Columbia has gone behind the moon on the 23rd lunar revolution. Be acquired again at, well, let's see now. It looks like we don't have acquisition table up yet for next rev. During this pass and the short conversation toward the end of the front side pass with Columbia, the network transmitters have been arranged so that the transmissions would not disturb the crew of Eagle, who at this time should still be asleep. Not since Adam has any human known such solitude as Mike Collins is experiencing during the 47 minutes of each lunar revolution when he's behind the moon with no one to talk to except his tape recorder aboard Columbia. While he waits for his comrades to soar with Eagle from Tranquility Base and rejoin him for the trip back to Earth, Collins, with the help of flight controllers here in Mission Control Center, has kept the command module systems going pocket up, pocket up, pocket up. At 121 hours, 12 minutes, ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control. Let's join the call to Tranquility Base.
How is the resting standing up there? Did you get a chance to curl up on the engine can?
Roger. Neil has rigged himself a really good hammock with a weight tether, and he's been lying on the at an engine cover, and I curled up on the floor. Over.
Roger. Copy, Buzz. Got a couple of changes to your surface checklist here, and in general, what we're going to want you to do is P-22 tracking the command module for one last hack on your position there. And this will be, you know, it was P-57, P-22, and then to press on with the checklist. And the rest of them are a couple of minor changes in the checklist. The main one being that we do not want the rendezvous radar on during the ascent. And we think that this will take care of some of the overflow program alarms that we're getting during descent.
Okay, we had the rendezvous radar in SLU during descent, though.
Tranquility Base, Houston, I missed that, say again.
Roger, I say again, we had the rendezvous radar switch in the SLU position, not the LGC position.
Roger, we copy that, but there's a greater duty cycle on
15% duty cycle.
There's a good 15% duty cycle on the ascent program there, so we'll just go ahead and leave it off. And I have the changes here. If you want to get out your surface checklist, I can go ahead and start giving them to you.
All right, go ahead. I've got it out.
Okay, before we start here, request POO and data, and we'll give you some vectors.
Now you've got POO and data.
Okay, and on surface 50 will be the first change there.
Okay, now I understand you want us to do a P-57 option 3 and then a P-22. Is that the general idea? Over.
That's affirmative. So on surface 50 there, down at the bottom of the page, just after PRO, after two recycles, stick in a time of 122 plus 15. Do P-22 as per pings 20 of GNN dictionary. Over.
Roger, understand at 122.15 to P-22 as per pings 20 GNN dictionary.
Roger. Okay, let's skip on over to surface 59.
Okay.
Okay, this is going to be for one last vent on the dips tank there. So at the top of the page, just after EPS inverter 1 close, add okay, after EPS inverter 1 close, add prop descent helium reg / vent close. And then after stabilization control AELD close, add prop displays / engine override
slash logic close. Over.
Roger, copy. These are two circuit breakers, right?
Tranquility Base, affirmative. Those are just the circuit breakers at that time. Tranquility Base, Houston, did you get those two on the propulsion circuit breakers?
Roger, I have those two.
Okay, let's go over to surface 60. And then down the middle of the page, after launch guidance system recommendation from Ms. Finn, I'm going to add the switches there.
Go ahead there.
Okay. After launch guidance system recommendation from Ms. Finn, add descent, propulsion, fuel vent, open. Add descent, propulsion, oxidizer, vent, open. Add verify, talk back, gray. Over.
Roger, descent propellant fuel vent open. Descent propellant oxidizer vent open. Verify talk back right.
Roger, you got that one? So that'll be the last vent and it'll continue venting. Skip over to surface 61. Down there at TIG minus 17.
John, there, go ahead.
Okay, at TIG minus 17, delete CB11, AC bus A, rendezvous radar close, wait 30 seconds, delete pings, rendezvous radar close, and then add up data link switch to voice backup. Over.
Roger, I have that. We'll leave those two circuit breakers open and have the up data link to voice backup, and we'll make the appropriate changes on the following circuit breaker status card.
Roger, and then you might add a little note down there at the bottom of the page. Note, this is the bottom of the page 61. Note, do not use tape meter in pings. I.e., do not place mode select switch to pings. Over.
Okay, we'll put it in ag.
Roger, fair enough. That's some more of that computer load business. Okay, that's all the changes we have for the checklist here. I've got some just some general notes I'll read to you on P-22 and just for some information. Over.
Okay, then it looks to me like we ought to get hopping on this P-57.
Roger, we agree wholeheartedly. And while you're starting on that, I'll just read these notes on P-22. Call P-22, possible program alarm 526, range greater than 400 nautical miles. And then use P-22 as described on Pings 20. Take option 1 in nouns 06 and use the no update mode. The rendezvous radar will lock on at about 25 degrees elevation above the horizon. If 503 alarm occurs, designate fail. Key A proceed and allow the rendezvous radar to search for the CSM. And place the range altitude monitor switch in altitude rate to prevent the tape meter from driving into the stops. And press on.
Roger, I think I have that.
This is Apollo Control. A little over 2 minutes until Columbia comes over the hill again and the 24th lunar revolution. In that wake-up call to Eagle, the crew described how they slept in the spacecraft by lying on the floor and on the engine cover. Some of the preliminary times being generated now for our ascent show ignition about 1 minute 26 seconds earlier than the pre-mission flight plan. Ignition time now showing 124 hours, 22 minutes, 0 seconds. The burn will have a magnitude of 6,068 feet per second. Quite a bit of that will be in vertical rise and actually starting from 0 feet per second on the lunar surface. The CSI maneuver behind the moon, the concentric sequence initiate, CSI acronym being for that maneuver, 125 hours, 19 minutes, 34 seconds. Constant delta height, CDH, 126 hours, 18 minutes, 0 seconds. Terminal phase initiation, 126 hours, 57 minutes, 0 seconds. And terminal phase finalization, or the final braking before docking, 127 hours, 39 minutes, 39.2 seconds. These are ground computations. And It'll be computed by the crew from radar tracking, rendezvous radar. So actually, these numbers computed on the ground are somewhat academic in that they will be computed in real time by the crew. We're standing by here for Capcom to resume conversation. During this upcoming pass here, a more definite fix on the Eagle's position will be attempted by using the rendezvous radar from the Eagle in Program 22, Rendezvous Radar Lunar Surface Navigation Program. The transponder on Columbia in the meantime has been warmed up. During the last revolution, Mike Collins was advised to have the transponder warmed up. As of now, the exact location is somewhat vague, and perhaps this rendezvous radar exercise will give a final, more pinpoint location of where Eagle does indeed nest on the moon. We'll continue to monitor the air ground circuit. We've had acquisition of signal with Columbia, so likely the conversation will increase here as we get the lock on, hopefully, with rendezvous radar as Columbia passes over the Eagle landing site. Still live on air ground.
Columbia, Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Columbia, Houston, over.
Houston, Columbia.
Roger, Columbia. We'd like a cryo stir, all four tanks, and a standard 1 minute, over. Roger, and do you have any torquing angles from P-52?
Roger, standby one.
Tranquility, Houston, request error reset at this time, over.
Roger, error reset, and would you tell me when you're satisfied with the LGC self-test?
Tranquility, LGC is a go.
Roger.
Torquing angles when you're ready.
Columbia, Houston, go ahead.
Roger, stars 25 and 42. Triangle difference 5 balls, now 93, plus 00165, plus 00186, minus 00039er. Time of torquing 121.15. Over.
Columbia, Houston, we copy. Thank you. Thank you, Columbia.
Houston, Tranquility. Would you like a recycle on the Verb 604? Over.
Tranquility, Houston, we copy. Standby one. Tranquility Houston, request recycle. Spacecraft calling Houston, say again. Roger, copy, Columbia. Tranquility, Houston, request rendezvous radar breakers in about now. Columbia, Houston, request Omni D, Omni Delta. Tranquility Base, Houston, request go ahead and start the warm-up on the rendezvous radar.
Roger.
Houston, you're copying now 93.
Tranquility, affirmative, go.
Roger, we're going to torque.
Houston, roger. Tranquility Base, Houston, Columbia will be overhead at 122 plus 22 plus 51. His LOS will be 2935.
Over. Roger.
Houston, we'd like to check this on the tape meter against the AGS. We'll go back to altitude rates as soon as the rate starts to build up. Over.
This is Apollo Control. We have confirmation of radar lock on.
Second thought, since that'll peg the range rate, I guess maybe we better not do that. And for this range that the AGS is showing now, 425 miles, with a signal strength of 2.2, that looks like we ought to proceed on this. Over.
Roger. Stand by one. Tranquility, affirmative, proceed.
Are you getting the information on the downlink now?
Tranquility, affirmative, and we're saving it. We've got 4 points so far, and it's looking good.
Okay, what do you people think about calling up a Verb 83?
Tranquility, Houston, stand by on that. We're getting good data now. We're checking on the Verb 83.
And we expect that we may lose lock when it passes overhead because of the max rate that the radar has.
Tranquility, Houston, negative on Verb 83.
Understand. We just lost lock.
Tranquility, Houston, go.
We just lost lock, Rob.
Roger. We had about 20-some points before you did that. And for your information, the reason the ags is
right,
a little different there. The reason the ags is a little different is because the K factor is a little bit wrong.
Has he already gone Okay. Okay, has he already gone overhead, or do you want to try and get a lock on again?
Houston, Columbia, you got noon 49.5, good morning.
Tranquility, affirmative, try to lock on again, and you'll lose him at about 29 minutes and 35 seconds.
Okay, do you have a real quick procedure how to do that?
Columbia, Houston, say again about your noun 49.
I say, I got 5 good marks, you got noun 49. When you get everything you need off the downlink, let me know, I'll proceed.
Columbia, Houston, stand by one.
Ron, did you say on a 526 alarm to proceed or do a Verb 32? Roger, that's his radar thinks that the range is greater than 400 miles now.
Tranquility Base, Houston, recommend you terminate P-22. Over.
Roger, will do.
And Columbia, Houston, same for you. You can terminate P-22.
I have. I'm already passed.
Roger.
I'm staying at P-22 here a second just to record to down 89 and then over 34.
Columbia, Houston, Roger, we copy, and that's good. Tranquility, Houston.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger, request S-band function switch to range. We're going to do some ranging on you. Also, I have an updated AGS K factor when you're ready to copy. Over.
Roger, go ahead with the K factor.
Roger, 119 plus 59 plus 59.92. Over.
All right, a little closer this time.
Yeah, sure.
59.92. Over.
Tranquility, Houston, read back correct. Columbia, Houston.
Houston, Tranquility. I see what you mean now about the K factor.
Roger.
That's Columbia, go ahead. And I'd like to know about this P-52 coming up. Is that the one I just completed, or do you want to pair up back to back?
Columbia, Houston, you do not need to do another P-52 unless you want to. Break, and also Columbia, when you get a chance, request BATC and the power roll readouts, over. Houston, Roger, we copy, thank you.
That bus B is 37. Now that bus A is 36, so I think the gauge is stuck.
Roger, and you're looking good to us, Columbia. Columbia, Houston, negative, standby on the VERP 45.
Roger that.
Columbia, Houston, we've got a couple more vectors to send up to you. They'll be coming up shortly, and then you can do the VERP 45 after you get those in. Over.
Okay, that's fine. Just want to make sure that we're both in sync on the order.
Roger. Columbia and Tranquility Base, this is Houston. In case you haven't noticed, the MISPIN relay is not activated. So I can go ahead and relay anything if you want to talk directly.
Be advised, we've got
coming right
about
again.
Going red right now. We just put a VERP 77 in. I believe this is
Tranquility Base, Houston. We've got a lot of static down here. Can you say again?
Indicating red. We still have the circuit breakers out as of right now. And I believe at the moment we have just entered a VERP 77 on page 352 and are ready to proceed with the hot fire. Is it normal to have these four red flags?
Okay, go ahead and reset them, and press on with a hot fire. Over. Columbia, Houston, request to and accept. We'll send some state vectors up to you.
Yeah, go to and accept.
Houston Tranquility, I used Capella on the last sighting, and it's a good ways near the edge, good ways away from the center of D-10-4. wondering if it would pay any to use Alperat's star number one. It might be a little closer. However, it would delay things a little since I'd have to designate the radar out of the way. Over.
Tranquility, Roger, we copy standby one. And break, Columbia. We're having a little trouble getting the stuff in there. Request high gain. Pitch, minus 20. Yaw, plus 150. Over. And Tranquility, Houston, we'd prefer to save the time. Press on with Capella, over.
Roger.
And Tranquility, Houston, the RCS check looked mighty fine to us.
And let's get up here.
Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Houston, in the blind, high gain, pitch, minus 20, yaw, plus 150.
Houston, Tranquility, could you give me the take portion of the ascent pad so I can load it in for P-57, over.
Tranquility, Roger, standby one. We want to wait on that P-57 until about take minus 50 minutes, over.
Roger.
Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Columbia, Houston, over.
Houston, Tranquility. It turns out that descent 4 is usable anyway with the yaw that we have because the Earth appears in both descent 2 and descent 3.
Tranquility, base Houston and Roger. Columbia, Houston, over. Tranquility, Houston, I have your landmass and CSI data pads when you're ready to copy.
We're ready to copy.
Roger, landmass and pad. TIG, 124, 22, 00, 00. Down 76. 55349 00322 plus 0017 Beta 47 plus 37104 -70470 +58604 +56936 Your LEM weight 10837 Your T-14, 126, +20, +12, over.
What, say again, the cross range in down 76?
Roger, your cross range for down 76. By the way, we may update this later. but now it is plus 0017. Over.
Roger. Read back follows. Take 124 22 0000 55349er 00322 plus 0017 plus 37104 minus 70470 plus 58604 plus 56936 Lamway 10837 T14 126 2012 go.
Tranquility Houston, roger, you read back correct. And now I have your CSI pad.
Go on to CSI pad.
Roger, CSI pad. TIG of CSI. 125. 193470 TIG of TPI 126570000 981 0532 plus 0000 FDAI NA Beta 373 03 196 Beta 275 04 170 986 plus 0532 plus 0000 plus 0012 Tranquility, read back.
Roger, CSI Apollo. Say it follows. Take 125 193470 Take of TPI 126 57 0000 981 0532 plus all zeros 373 03 196 275 0417 0 986 plus 0532 plus 0000 plus 0012 go.
Tranquility Base, Houston, your read back is correct. And Tranquility, no need for any gyro compensation. It's go.
Roger, understand.
Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Houston, in the blind, request high gain, pitch, minus 30, yaw, plus 170, over.
Houston, Columbia on the high gain, over.
Roger, Columbia. We still need to finish your uplink there. And then I have your CSI and TPI times, and also the liftoff.
Go ahead, ready, copy.
Roger, LIM ascent liftoff time, 124, 22, 00, 00. Your CSI TIG, I say again, CSI TIG, 125, 19, 34, 70. Your TIG of TPI, 126, 57, 00, 00. And the LEMS 981 values for CSI, 0532, that's 53.2 for Delta VX, Delta VY, all zeros. Columbia, Houston, over.
Roger, I read back liftoff TIG 124, 22 even. CSI 125, 19, 34, 70. DPI 126, 57 even. LEMS 981 for CSI 53.2 Delta VX, over.
Columbia, Houston, Roger, you read back correct. Columbia, Houston, we're coming up with your second load now.